Everyone in Babylon heard about the new law, including Daniel. But Daniel also knew God's law, and God's law told him that he should only pray to God. So the next day, just like every other day, Daniel prayed and thanked God for the sunshine and for all his friends. He also thanked God for giving him the courage to do what was right, even when he knew it could get him in trouble.
Did you say trouble? So you guys are wise men. That's pretty cool. Have you always been wise? You have to go to school for that. Are you serious about that cheese ball thing? Hey, I can see my house from here.
Daniel, because you violated section 42192R94006.1-7B of the Code of Babylon forbidding prayer to anyone but King Darius, you are hereby sentenced to be consumed by the lions. Goodbye.
Hey, don't I get a phone call? Hey, Daniel, you're sure gonna have fun down there. We're not lying.
Yeah, you better be lying down, because those lions are gonna, lie on you.
What? Mine was funny. Yours was goofy. Lions are gonna lie on you? They're gonna eat them. They're not gonna lie on him!
Well, maybe they're gonna lie on him, then eat him. Or one will lie on him while another one maybe eats him. Or, well, maybe one will sit
on
him.
Like lions are gonna cooperate? Like one's gonna lie on him and say, hey, you eat him, I'll lie on him. Come on, we're the ones that are lying, not the lion. Oh, it's not so scary down here. A little musty, but not so scary. Oh no, what am I gonna do? It looks like I'm gonna end up as lions too.
Don't cry, Daniel. Fear not, Daniel. Don't you And though it seems this time you won't get through, God has made a way.
Even though he still didn't know what to expect, Daniel felt better when he remembered that God was taking care of him, even in the lion's den. Elsewhere in the kingdom, the wise men were busy congratulating themselves for being so clever. While the king, believing that he had lost a good friend, decided the only thing he could do was to pray that Daniel's God would protect him.